look like these IG girls. Ever. And Josia, we are going to be talking about body image and social media because I feel like I gotta get this rant out. And you guys really need a perspective from someone that is in the industry, okay? So I've been on social media for a couple years now. I've been making money from it. It's been my full-time job for a while. And there's a lot of things that you guys genuinely do not know. It really hurts me to the core that one of the main messages, emails, and like letters I get to my PO box is about girls and even men, like just people struggling with body image due to social media.
Ivana, thank you so much for your channel. You definitely helped me see the good in me. I used to struggle with my body image and I hated my dark skin and my 4C hair, but you genuinely made me love myself.
Ivana, thank you so much for your videos. You definitely helped me understand that there are women out there who will love me for me and genuinely take me as I am. I used to be insecure at looking at other men on social media, but because of your content, I've definitely learned to love myself.
It really be that deep. I know I've seen a couple girls on Instagram and I'm like, ooh, child, her ass fat. I need that. Let me bust a squat, you feel me? But it's never been to the extent where I've been like, I really hate myself because I'm looking at other people and wanting to be them. I literally had to ask around, compile some data, and do a lot of research to bring this to you, okay? The reason you feel that way is mainly because of you, not because of nobody else. You don't like yourself and you're literally trying to be someone else. And until you rectify that, you're not going to get anywhere. You can do whatever you want. You can get plastic surgery. You can wear as much makeup as you want. You can get new clothes. You can make as much money as you want to be as happy as you think you're gonna be. If you do not get right with yourself in yourself, you ain't gonna go nowhere, period.
Yeah, editing me again. I'm just fucking up with remembering to say these things when I'm filming. But also please keep in mind that when you are wishing to be like someone and wishing to have someone else's life, you also inherit their demons because you are practically asking to be like them. No one is perfect. And most importantly, social media is a facade. No one is showing you all of their complications in life. So when you're asking to be like someone, you are literally inheriting all of their bad energy as well. Be very, very careful what you wish for.
So that's first things first. Self-love is the root of all problems. A lot of people were not instilled with self-love at all. Like, I don't think that's a thing that many parents really think about. I feel like a lot of people just think about other things and focus on other things when it comes to raising kids. Not many people go out of their way to teach their kids like, hey, you should love yourself. Hey, you know, in the real world, they're gonna say that you're not beautiful because this is the beauty standard, but you are beautiful. So that's first step, get right with yourself, okay? If you guys are not aware, I do have a YouTube Facebook group for my media hustle company, which is a company where I help people grow their YouTube channels. So if you guys want one-on-one consultation or you want to just join a YouTube group, I will be doing free webinars time and time again, as well as offering free YouTube type of advice. Make sure you guys head down to the description or in the pinned comment down below. Make sure you guys join my throne. It is a The Mafia group chat. Everything you need is down there. Make sure you get your merchandise. This is my $1 million melanin hoodie, and I have a new sweatshirt, t-shirt, a lot of other things in the shop. Make sure you guys go check it out. I feel like we all have those tiny little things we want to change about ourselves, whether it's a flatter stomach, a bigger butt, some bigger boobs. Shit, I want smaller boobs because I got a whole lot of chest going. But I feel like we all want to change things. There's nothing wrong with that. Everyone has like their little bit of insecurities, but there's a difference between being insecure and having insecurities. You are human and you are bound to have insecurities, but when you're genuinely insecure to the point where you cannot be yourself, you don't want to be yourself, you want to literally go through life-threatening surgery to change yourself, that's when it becomes a problem. When you're literally sitting there comparing yourself to other people, that's a problem. When you want to do something to please someone else and not you. Like, don't we find it strange that people would much rather go under the knife to change something about themselves than book a couple of therapy sessions to realize and understand what's wrong with them. No one's ever found that strange. Nope, just me? Okay. Body image is a very touchy subject. I've been body shamed numerous times when I was really, really small, up to now at my normal weight, up to before at my biggest weight. I've been body shamed forever, and it genuinely does not feel good. I'm gonna tell you this right now, it doesn't. If you've never been body shamed before, it's pretty bad. That's probably one of the only things I could say that actually kind of like grinds my gears. Like, I have a very, very select few things that actually really bother me and get under my skin. Being body shamed is one. And I can say social media has definitely played a part in that. Not in the sense of me scrolling and being like, oh my God, I want her body. But in the sense of other people thinking that these bodies are realistic and trying to compare that to other people. It really bothers me when people find it necessary to go comment on other people's pictures like,
you're badly built. Oh my God, you need to go lose some weight. Damn, you look unhealthy.
I'm definitely worried about you. Like,
no, you just want to be a bitch, and I will bitch you like the bitch you are behind that damn computer keyboard because you think that's okay to say to people. Like, if you're one of those people, just don't. Just really don't. It's just not okay. Whether someone has gained weight or lost weight, it's not okay to comment on it. And I know a lot of people always associate like losing weight with good things, but to be honest, a lot of people lose weight involuntarily. A lot of people lose weight due to illness. So it's like pointing out someone's weight is just a really low blow and can really take someone over the edge. So please be mindful before you say things like that. Body image is important because it is essentially how you see yourself. If you do not love the way you look, the way you feel, you're genuinely not going to be happy. With that being said, your body image is affected by a lot of things. Culture, society, and in this case, social media, which is actually part of society, but not really, because there's a greater part of society that's not on social media whatsoever. So with social media, we already see the standard of beauty, okay, as of right now, 2020. Small waist, big boobs, big butt, lighter skin, curly hair, lighter eyes, lighter everything, but with black features. Pretty much. Now everyone is striving for this, okay? The white girls don't want to be white. The black girls don't want to be black. We have a whole bunch of nonsense going on. We got the black fishing. We got the white fishing. It's like, nah, I don't know. I don't even know if that's really a thing. You get the point. You got dark-skinned girls trying to bleach their skin. You got white girls trying to darken their skin. The next thing you guys need to know is this is all a facade, okay? Social media is not real, okay? It's not real at all. These people are liars, okay? These people are filtering the hell out of their photos. They know how to take their photos as well. If you want to look good on Instagram for real or in any picture, know your angles. I know how to pose to make my butt look a little bigger or know how to make my stomach a little flatter. I know how to pose to make my face look a little slimmer or just look better in a picture. Like, everyone that's a social media personality knows this. So a lot of times, these girls do not look the way you think they do, okay? There's actually pages on Instagram that you can look up right now that will show you what these celebrities and IG thoughts look like without the editing, without the posing, without the angles, because these paparazzis be catching them slipping, okay? Before they edit the picture, this is what they really be looking like. So do not feel bad that you don't look like these people, because a lot of times it's nowhere near realistic, okay? They edit the hell out of their photos. A lot of these YouTubers, Instagrammers, Twitterers, TikTokers edit the fuck out of their stuff. Now your cars are probably like, no, but I've seen videos. You can edit video too. I just found this out and I'm just like, oh my God. Mes amis, where have we gone as a society? Yes, you can indeed edit your videos. Like Facetune videos, essentially. Like, it's a thing. There's people out there that really make themselves look skinnier, lighter, darker through video. It's not a common practice because it's pretty hard to do, but it's very much so possible. You need to understand that what you're attaining and trying to be is not realistic. These people are literally lying to you and you are taking the bait. You are falling for it because you yourself need to understand that you are all you need and you need to be your own body goal. You need to be your own body image for you. You can't look at someone else's body and say, damn, I want that body. You could look at somebody and be like, damn, you know, I want a six pack like her. But when you sit there, you're like, oh, I want that body. That becomes a problem, especially when you're willing to go under the knife to achieve it. And that brings me to my next point. A lot of these girls get so much plastic surgery that it's ridiculous. Now, Whether you're pro plastic surgery or anti plastic surgery, I am definitely anti plastic surgery. You need to know that these girls are lying to you. I'm going to link a plethora of videos down below of white girls, Spanish girls, black girls talking about how they went under the knife and it's been a disaster for them. And I know there's gonna be still people out there battling with their self-consciousness and trying to convince themselves that they need a BBL, that they need a boob job, that they need some ass shots to feel good about themselves. Social media is a joke. Like, even though it's my job and I love social media, like, it's just a joke because it's like, people really believe this shit. 99.9% of it is fake, it's a facade, it's a lie, and it's all to get you to spend your money. Okay, that's really what it is. It's there to spend your money. And you're there to capture niggas' engagement. Take it from the people that are down in the description box below. It's not fucking worth it. A BBL is not just a BBL. A lot of people actually have to go in for corrections. A lot of these girls that get breast implant sickness. A lot of these girls with these ass shots have sagging ass booties, but they're not going to tell you that. They're going to sell you on the dream of,
oh, well, I got my ass done, look at me. Oh, I got this BBL, look at that.
They're lying. A lot of these bitches are miserable. Okay, I'm not talking about the girls that I tag. Letting y'all know. I'm not talking about the girls. I'm not talking shit about them. I'm saying, like, a lot of these girls are miserable and really regret their decisions. A lot of people have gone through these procedures and realized that it wasn't worth it because it wasn't just a one-shot situation. It didn't help them feel better. Now, after doing that one procedure, now they want to do 2, 3, 4, 5. A lot of the times, a lot of people do not make it out of the operation room. There are people that have died from getting these procedures. Before you go and get a procedure, please think. Make it make sense to yourself. Please reevaluate yourself and think about, first of all, why am I doing this? Am I doing this for me? Am I doing this for the attention? Am I doing this for social media? Just why? Now, the thing is, there's a lot of people that love to say, oh, I'm
doing it for me so I can look good.
Look good for what?
Oh, I'm doing it so I can look good for me.
If you're doing it for you, why don't you think you look good now? Let's be real.
Oh, because I don't got a fat ass. I don't got fat.
Okay, who told you you needed a fat ass? Who told you you needed big titties? Please let me know. Comment down below because this makes no sense to me. Like, this whole argument of, oh, I want to look good for me bullshit when it comes to plastic surgery is nonsense. No, you want to look good to impress other people. You want to gain the attention of man. You want to gain the attention of social media. Okay, because you're clearly lacking something as an inner child. That's what the fuck is going on here. You want social media to please other people. It's not for you. You're not, no. Stop lying to yourself. Once you're real with yourself, life will become a lot easier. You most likely want this surgery so you can impress other people. And unless you're making money from social media, I don't see the point. Like, I'll never understand people that have no social media follow, no nothing, that just get surgery. Like, if you're really a social media person and you really want to make more money, go get a BBL. You're going to skyrocket in views, likes, money. Because you can fit into the curve of your clothes, it means you will get more sponsorships because that's the thing right now. It means that you are going to get more likes and comments because that's the thing right now. You feel me? So if you're doing it for that, I get it. But at the same time, what's going to happen when that's not the style no more? For those youngins watching this, it's not always the beauty standard. The beauty standard was actually being very thin, like very, very like Lindsay Lohan, like skinny, slim, thick type situation. Not even slim, thick, like slim, like looking like a Slim Jim slim. That was the beauty standard at one point. Around that time, before that, it was boob jobs. So people just really went out for the boob jobs, getting like super humongous boobs, really, really tiny waist. So it's like, okay, so when this dies out, what you gonna do? So you went to go purposely throw yourself under the knife. Not even one time, because you're gonna have to go multiple times. Don't listen to these bitches, they're lying to you. They're not drinking flat tummy tea. They're not exercising a damn fucking thing. They are getting surgery. And they're not telling you about their complications. Now you're probably like, oh, but I know this creator, she was still posting while these photos were taken before their surgery. Okay? Let me tell you this right now. A lot of them go through complications. A lot of them have to go under the knife more than one time. And a lot of them are miserable with the results. You're going to do all of that to yourself, all for the acceptance of other people. Is that what you're telling me right now? Don't do it. If anything, spend the money on a plethora of therapy. I kid you not, it will do you well. It will definitely serve you purpose for a long amount of time. And most importantly, it will last. Because another thing about plastic surgery that you guys need to understand is you have to go back and get touch-ups every so often. Sometimes you have to add certain things, lift certain things. It's not a one and done type of situation. This is a lifelong commitment. So whatever you want to do, please make sure you do your research because it's super duper important when it comes to the surgery aspect. Your mental health is important and you definitely need to take care of that before anything else, or else you're gonna keep going under the knife until you look real, real fucking crazy and you can't get out of it. Body standards change every so often, okay? Like every 10 years, there's a new body standard, okay? Whether it's big hips, big butt, big thighs, big titties, big head, whatever. It's always a different beauty standard, okay? Blonde hair, blue eyes, kinky hair, brown hair, blue eyes, 3C hair. Like, it's always different. Do not let the internet or anyone dictate what you think is beautiful. If you think you're beautiful, that is all that matters. If you don't think you're beautiful, you need psychological help. About like, what can I do? Social media is all around us. Well, the first thing you can do is stop fucking following people you know are making you feel bad about yourself. Seriously. Like, why sit there and follow people you know you envy to an extent? If you're following someone specifically because, oh my gosh, she's so pretty, I want to be like her. Why can't I be like her? Why my hair don't look like her? Why my makeup don't look like that? Why my eyes don't look like that? Why my lips don't look like that? You're envying her.
And he looks so good. He get all the bitches. He got abs. I want a six pack like that.
You're envying him. Okay, period. That is envy. You want to be like this person. And you can't. And you never will. And someone had to tell you that, okay? You can't. And I'm usually the first to tell y'all, you could be whatever you want to be. I mean, yeah, with a lot of fucking consequences in this case. You will never look like these people. This is unrealistic beauty standard, okay? And for those who have seen these people in real life, you guys are probably not convinced. Let me tell y'all about Photoshop, okay? You can do anything on Photoshop that you want to. Photoshop can make you look like a goddamn god, okay? And if you're not good with Photoshop, you can actually hire people on Fiverr to make you look better. There's actually YouTube videos of people who have hired people on Fiverr to make them look better. If you guys are not aware what Fiverr is a platform where you can get creative services done for you. So banners, logos, book covers, and in this case, you can get someone to edit your Instagram picture to make you have more boobs, more butt, more of a tan, or whatever the case may be. This is absolutely disgusting. Yeah, I know, it's ridiculous. These are the secrets of the underground social media world. And a lot of people do it. And what's crazy about it is a lot of creators will actually admit to this. They will tell you like, yeah, I got surgery. Oh yeah, that's Photoshop. Like, they'll tell you. But my thing is, I feel like there has to be some type of regulation on this. They have to be able to say like, this has been Photoshop. This has been heavily edited. Like, I feel like there has to be disclaimers. I feel like social media is having a damper on a lot of people's mental health. I feel like a lot of people genuinely believe that they can look like that. And it's absolutely not possible. You can only be you and you can only look like you. Even with surgery, that's why a lot of these surgeries get botched. People go in trying to get surgery, trying to get unrealistic shit, end up looking fucking crazy as shit because it's not realistic in the first place. But the doctor gonna take your money anyway because shit, it's money and shit, I think I can do it, but they can't. So you end up looking like fucking cucaracha and shit, trying to get a waist, trying to get some ass, trying to get some titties for what? Trying to look like these people for what? What do these people do for you? What is getting a fat ass and titties gonna do for you? Please let me know. And do not fucking sit there and say yourself because that's not what it is. Please stop hiding under your insecurities by saying that you want to do things for yourself, okay? When it comes to looking nice, even wearing makeup, even wearing a wig, you can say, oh, I like the way I look in this. I'll give you a pass for that. But for you to literally go under the knife, for you to actually go sit there and literally put your life at risk to impress other people, that is not doing it for yourself. People need to stop perpetuating the culture of letting people do toxic things and pushing other people to do it. I hate this new society because it feels like everyone is just piggybacking off of everyone. It feels like everyone just does shit just because everyone else is doing it and they don't think about the true consequences of their actions. I feel like a lot of people just do things because, oh, well, Kim K did it, ta-ta-ta did it, so I could do it too. I could look like that. I could be like this. That is a horrible mindset to have about anything, y'all. I'm telling you this right now. The key to everything in life, whether it's happiness, career success, brand success, business success, love success, is to love and accept yourself for who you are. Stop looking at other people. Stop trying to be other people. Stop regretting things you can't change. Stop dwelling over things you can't change and accept you for you and accept that you are special. Accept that you are one of a kind. That's something that every single one of us have. Not one person can be like us. Even an identical twin, I mean, even though y'all kind of share the same DNA, you will always be you. Okay? No one can replicate you, and that's special. And I feel like more people need to realize that shit. Really sad. Like, you can do whatever you want to your edits. Like, I'm sure you can do that. Like, y'all, this wig is out of whack. But I'm sure you can get the edits down. You can do the same edits as them. There's a lot of these Instagram girls that actually sell the same presets that they use in their Lightroom, you know, just to edit it better or whatever. You need to understand that it's not gonna help. Like, it really isn't. People, like, if you're watching this, understand that your validation is not in likes, followers, subscribers, men, women, people, anything. Your validation is within yourself. That's why no matter how much money you make, no matter how many changes you make to yourself, no matter how many followers you get, no matter how many likes you get, you will always feel empty. Always. Until you get right with yourself. With that being said, let me know down in the comment section below, what do you think about social media and body image? Do you think it is messing it up? Do you think that it is not messing it up? Do you want to get plastic surgery? Why or why not? Make sure you comment down below, and please make sure you check out all the videos that I posted in my description and my pinned comment if you are considering getting a BBL or any other type of surgery. With that being said, make sure you like, share, subscribe. Be sure to choose you always. And I'ma see y'all next time.